And I'm fully with you all the statements you made about the yogis and about their present situation. And if you were to say this so bad, but also important, how to now have a question reflecting on our issues. Young people today, that's a statement that I would like to make, is the most powerful generation ever in the history of mankind. Because this generation is totally different than any other generation in history because of the power of technology in their mind. And that's what we're talking about, social media. Because now they are constantly in touch with each other, instantaneously, as communication. And this makes also another difference. In previous generation, young people in poorer countries were not yet known that they exist. Today you cannot do that. Because mobile phone is everywhere. No matter which country you look at, every single young person has a mobile phone, which are internet connected smartphones. So internet is at its disposal. All you can do, Mr. Secretary General, to make broadband free for everybody, for all young people, you'll see the whole world will change right away. And this is one thing we must focus on. And when we talk about the young people, we do not forget the young people. Because previously, young men always a young man, not young woman. Today, there is no distinction whether it's a remote village or in the city center. They are equally powerful. That power is at their hand, but they are not aware of it. The question we all have to raise that make them aware, how to make them aware they have a tremendous power at their hand, and how to use that power. We are always referring to young people as the future. That is the old way of referring. We have to get used to the fact that young people is the present. The center of gravity of power has to shift. It's not on the side of the age anymore. Is it on the side of the talent, on the side of the creativity, on the side of the speed? You cannot beat the speed of the young people today with any other generation or any other age group exists today. So that is the power that we have to mobilize and so on. Then, for some reason, I have over 2 million followers in Google Plus. And these are all young people. They are looking for something. Young people are hungry for action, hungry for changing the world with themselves. But we are refusing to do that. We are making barriers after barriers that they cannot get in. So it's not only saying you are the future, we have to integrate them in an institutional way. If you believe, I hear Mr. Secretary General, you're thinking about bringing young people into the United Nations. I applaud it to the highest applause that I can give you for that. You have to integrate people into the system. It's not just saying you're good, go ahead, do it. They have the power to achieve things which others cannot do, governments cannot do, others do, institutions cannot do. But young people that have the power. And when I say young again, I'm not talking referring to the 30 or 25. I'm talking about 11 and 12. They already have so much power in their capacity. Even the 7-year-old has the capacity right now. So we have to admit that capacity and make them flourish that capacity. Mr. Secretary General, we are moving into the what we call millennium tour of the young people to explain to them how they can be integrated into their MDG goals and own this and change it, which is lacking in many countries. I hope your institution will give us the full support so that we can address that. There are so many things they can do. They have the ability to design technology and make it happen across. Today, in only the last 20 years, all the technology changes happened. But imagine what will happen in the next 20 years. It will be like a fiction, science fiction. So we should be preparing for that, ready to hand over, ready to shift the center of gravity in the favor of the young people that we have. And we have to give them the hunger that they have. We have to provide the action, provide the direction to choose from. And you mentioned about the unemployment among the young people. What a shame this powerful young generation remained wasted. What kind of system we have that we kind of waste our energy and creativity in the world in such a casual way as if nothing happened. If the system cannot solve that problem, it's not the problem of the young people, it's the problem of the system. If that system cannot solve this problem, throw away that system. We create a new system where everybody will be employed, everybody will be busy. Employment doesn't mean a job. Employment means the contribution that you can make and make the world in a better place. Let's get ready for that work. Thank you very much.